Hello dear students, we are continuing with our topic on super finishing process. This is part 2 of this video in which we are continuing with the further super finishing process. So further super finishing, in super finishing another process is, which is called as super finishing or surface finishing. So super finishing is a micro finishing process that produces a controlled surface condition on parts which is not obtained by any other method. The operation is also called as micro stoning. Micro stoning means we are using a surface removal which is in microns, that's why it is called as, and we are using one abrasive stone for it, that's why it is called as micro stoning. It consists of a scrubbing a stone against a surface to produce a fine quality metal finish. The process consists of removing chatter marks and fragmented or smear metal from the surface of dimensionally finished parts. So dimensionally the part should be finished, then you have to perform the super finishing operation. As much as 0.03 to 0.05 mm of stock can be efficiently removed with some production application, the process becomes most economical if the metal removal is limited to 0.005 mm. So in this particular process also we are having certain stone which is used to remove the material from the surface, and that stone is bonded with certain abrasives. So schematic illustration of super finishing process: a cylindrical part which is rotated between the centers. You can see here it is rotated in this direction about the centers, and this is the stone which is used for finishing this surface, and this stone is held in a pressure certain, what we can say here, a certain clamp which is applying pressure to this stone against this workpiece, as well as it is oscillating continuously. Or if I want to perform centerless operation, so these are the two roles. We have seen this particular centerless grinding also. Same principle is applied over here. So instead of that grinding wheel, we are having a separate stone which is used for performing the super finishing operation. Then next process is called as polishing. So generally polishing is performed in order to obtain a good lustrous surface, and that surface should be a mirror like surface. Okay, so in polishing, it is carried out with the help of polishing wheel. Abrasive grains are bonded by gluing to the outside periphery of the wheel. So you can see here this wheel is rotated, and this is the part we are polishing. So the abrasive materials are bonded on the periphery of this wheel. Then after the abrasive have been worn down and used up, the wheel is replenished with the grits. So when these particular abrasive on this particular wheel are worn down, then it is redressed. Redressing is nothing but the applying of the additional abrasive on that particular wheel, or another term we can say that we are redressing the abrasive on this particular wheel. So that's why it is also called as redressing of the abrasives. Okay, so now depending on the grit size, polishing is divided into three categories. First is called as rough polishing, second finish polishing, and third fine finish polishing. So first, rough polishing, the grit size is maintained from 20 to 80 grits. In finish polishing, the grit size is kept from 80 to 120 grit, and in fine finish the grit size is maintained above 120 grit. In case of fine finish, process oil allow beeswax is used as a lubrication agent. So this is the standard polishing with the help of polishing machine. You can see here a abrasive slurry is used in order to polish the surface. These abrasives are having that grade of grit that we are talking about in the previous slide. This is the blocking tool which is providing the pressure or the oscillation movement workpiece over the workpiece, and this is the slurry part. This is the slurry part which is between the rotational and translationary tool and between the workpiece, and this is the base of the polisher, and this spindle is also rotated continuously, so that workpiece is also rotated in this direction. You can see here, so the workpiece is also rotated in this direction. Okay, so now let us talk about the polishing tool. So polishing tool can be polishing generally is done by hand. You must have observed this type of polishing tool while we perform polishing on our cars or bikes also. So you must have observed this is the one of the type of handheld polishing tool. Or if I want to perform a polishing on a specially designed semi-automatic and automatic polishing machine, then those type of machines are also available for mass or job production. So here the abrasive particles of Al2O3 or diamond are used, and carrier of abrasive particle has already been discussed previously. Then polished surface may be buffed to obtain the even finer surface. So we are going to see what is buffing operation. So in polishing, basically what we are doing, we are removing the grinding marks or the lapping marks which are on the surface, and we are getting a luster, good luster and good surface finish over the surface. Polishing does not improve the dimensionless accuracy as done by the lapping. So it is as discussed here, the polishing does not improve the dimensional accuracy, means it is removing very small grade of material. That's why it is said here that it is does not improve the dimensional accuracy, but it improves the surface roughness of the material. So let us see what is the difference between lapping and polishing. Lapping and polishing differ in the following manner. Polishing produces a shiny surface, but lapping does not produce a bright and shiny surface. So this is the first difference. Second difference, lapping removes metal from surface to be finished. However, polishing removes negligible amount of metal. Third difference, lapping involves cutting action, but polishing consists of producing a kind of plastic flow of the surface crystal so that the high spots are made to fill the low spots. Okay, so lapping, it cuts the surface, and whereas in polishing, high spots are made to fill the low spots, means we are just deforming the material. For example, if we are considering here, this is the type of surface that I want to polish. So instead of let us use another type of ink here. So instead of removing this surface completely, unlike in the case of lapping, what we are doing, we are deforming this surface in this particular manner in order to decrease this height. So the height, this height h, this height h, we are decreasing, and it is decreasing till this grade. So this is decreased height h. Then we will see what is buffing. Buffing is the process. Buffing is the process used to shine the metal, wood or composite using a cloth wheel impregnated with cutting compound or roughs. The cloth buff holds the carries the compound, while the compound does the cutting. So cloth is only used so that it is what we can say, the cloth is continuously rubbed on the surface along with these rodges. Okay, and these are performing the cutting operation. So basically, why we are doing the buffing operation?
to shine the metal, wood or composites. So now buffing generally require two operation, a cut buff and a finish buff. So in cut buff we are basically cutting certain surface, and in finishing operation we are just improving the surface finish. Even the cut buff, which is the coarsest buffing operation, is too fine for removal of peat, coarse abrasive polishing lines or deep scratches. So deep scratches, coarse abrasive polishing lines, peats cannot be removed by using the coarse buff, and this is why the surface preparation prior to buffing is critical to high luster or final finish. So generally buffing operation is the most means last operation as far as the surface roughness treatment are considered. So as in polishing, buffing is usually done manually, although machines have been designed to perform the process automatically. So again, it is generally done manually, but if I want to perform job or batch production, then I can perform it by using certain specialized machine. So excellent pre-buff surface preparation starts with using the finest abrasive belt that production will allow. It is from this point the removal of the original scratch line needs to be accomplished to achieve the final buff finish. The original scratch or polish followed by one or two additional polishing steps. Cross polishing the abrasive line if possible, that buff of approximately 400 grit or finer abrasive of the metals. So we are, first of all, we are performing, just for example, we are performing in this direction. So then again, while next taking the next cut, we have to perform in this direction. Okay, so this is the way of the buffing. The cut buff will remove the final polishing line but may not be as bright as required. The finishing buff will produce the luster. Buffing wheels are made of disc of line, linen, cotton, broadcloth or canvas. So this is the buffing wheel, this is the buffing compound, this is the cloth which is bounded on the buffing wheel, and this is the work part. This is the schematic of the buffing operation. You must have observed in the metallurgy lab also, these are the various types of buffing wheels. So this is the cloth bias type buffing wheel. This type of buffing wheel we have observed in our metallurgy lab, that is full disc loose buffing wheel. Then this is the finger segment type cloth bias buffing wheel. This is the spiral sieve base type sisal buffing wheel. So these are the various types of the buffing wheels. So green roach, white roach and red roach are basically different types of the slurry or the abrasive that we are using on this fabrics. So it is, green roach is primarily used for final finish coloring buff operation on stainless steel, brass, aluminium, nickel and chrome, and the green roach is the chrome oxide, and it is considered the best all around luster compound, whereas white roach, which is white in color and it is made up of calcite alumina, that is unfused type, and primarily used in the final finish, that is coloring of steel, stainless steel and zinc. This compound is also a favorite in coloring aluminium and brass. Coloring means what? Obtaining that luster on that particular compound. And red roach is primarily used in the final finish coloring of gold and silver. It is the finest of all roaches, and the abrasive is ferric oxide. So what is important over here? Red roach, in red roach, the compound is what? Stainless steel, brass, aluminium. The green roach is chrome oxide. Here it is a calcite alumina fused type, and here it is a ferric oxide. Okay, so we are going to stop here for this particular video. Further, we will be discussing about the upcoming surface finishing operations in the part 3 of this video. So these are my references which I have referred while preparation of these slides, and thank you very much.